The front space we use as a gallery space. Once a month, we try to invite an artist to come and do something on board. That's the basic function of the boat.
Andrea Puerta, who's doing performances at the moment.
She's going to do her dance performance in about 6 different cities. We're going to travel with the boat and stop in villages and small places and do her performance.
You can take it to people in an easier way than if you had to organize it in all the different towns. You've got your own space which you take with you.
Hello?
Hello.
Hi, Andrea.
Hello.
How are you?
I was wondering if it would be okay for me to... I want to describe a place for you.
Light coming in through the window. Bed, a single side bed. And on top of the dressing table, there's a photograph. It's a little girl with a white bow on her head. And nothing else. And then there is... in front of by the bed, there is a wardrobe, a very large wardrobe, again, wooden, dark wooden wardrobe with sliding doors. And it's very high, it goes from the floor to the ceiling. And that's it.
Okay. Bye, Andrea.
Bye.
Bye-bye, thank you.
I put when I come in. There. And then there. Yeah. Yeah, that's better.
Can I be critical? Can I be like really annoying? And I think if the phone's here, and just testing if it's there, then what kind of a space does that create? It also creates a different space. Most of the projects that we do, they're always related to this boat, or they have a reason why it's happening on the boat. It's not like an ordinary white cube, which would find in normal gallery or... It means for me and for my family that we can travel and we're working at the same time. So we're making a living at the same time as we travel, and that gives a very nice sense to the boat.
Me and the children, we're always part of those events.
So we're not just traveling as a holiday or for fun, traveling for work.